On Friday, January 19, 2024, Japan officially asserted its status as a space power with the successful landing of its slim spacecraft on the lunar surface. Launched in September 2023, the slim lander touchdown is reported by telemetry readings from the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. Hiroshi Yamakawa, the president of JAXA, confirmed the successful soft landing and the spacecraft's ability to transmit signals post-descent. However, something weird happened that could compromise the mission's future. That's pretty sad, isn't it? Keep watching the video to get to know what actually happened and what impact this could have on the mission. Motivations. Everybody knows humanity is looking to expand its borders to the solar system and beyond. As you might have heard, the plan is to start off with the moon. Colonies of trained and carefully selected astronauts will first set foot on our beautiful natural satellite. Then it will be time for the common citizens of the world, just like you and me, to get in their suits and leave. If everything goes well, we will probably be considered the very first conquerors of the solar system, taken that no other forms of life existed before as capable of leaving their home planet and going to spend their lives on another celestial body. This would probably take us a long time. But something is moving in the underground of the scientific community. Space agencies all over the world are already investing money in ambitious projects to send astronauts to the moon. However, this is a very hard task to accomplish. Imagine spending a lot of time, resources, and money only to get your probe crashed thanks to a failed soft landing on that regolith surface. Or even worse, picture a manned spacecraft not capable of landing on the correct spot. The whole mission would be, in that case, be compromised, and the crew members would find themselves in despair, knowing that they will not be able to perform the experiments they have been trained for. Extremely precise landing procedures have to be tested before any human can set foot on the moon, in order to ensure a safe and a fruitful mission. This is where a mission like SLIM, proposed by Japan, comes in handy. SLIM's objectives. SLIM, which stands for Smart Lander for Investigating Moon Mission, aims to explore the lunar surface, conducting critical experiments and investigations to enhance our understanding of Earth's celestial neighbor. Kicking off in 2023, SLIM's journey began with a rideshare along the X-ray Imaging and Spectroscopy mission, XRISM. After separating from XRISM, SLIM executed translunar orbit injection burns in October 2023. By December 25, 2023, it gracefully entered lunar orbit, setting the stage for a historic soft landing on January 19, 2024. Notably, SLIM marks Japan's position as the fifth country to achieve this lunar feat. The roots of SLIM trace back to 2005 as the Small Lunar Landing Experiment satellite. Fast forward to 2013, SLIM was among seven proposals for ISAS's competitively chosen medium-sized focus mission. In 2024, it passed the semi-final selection, securing its spot. From April 2016, SLIM became a full-fledged JAXA project, with Mitsubishi Electric awarded the contract for spacecraft construction in May of 2016. The most important objective of the mission was to showcase a groundbreaking demonstration of precise pinpoint landing technology on a celestial body with gravity. In the era of high-resolution imaging data from spacecraft, the focus has shifted from landing somewhere on the moon to landing exactly at a specific point. Unlike conventional lunar landings with kilometer-level accuracy, SLIM has achieved pinpoint landing technologies with a remarkable 100-meter accuracy. The SLIM working group has tirelessly researched and developed novel technologies to enable this level of navigation accuracy. Innovative solutions include proposed algorithms for practical crater detection and recognition, forming an image-based guidance system deployable on existing space-qualified FPGA devices. A new landing radar system, rigorously evaluated through field flight tests with a breadboard model, enhances the mission's capability. Additionally, the project delves into detecting and avoiding potential obstacles around the landing area based on camera imagery. The Sea of Nectar was chosen as a landing site. This is a plain within which the impact crater Scioli is found. Scientists suspect the Sea of Nectar was formed by ancient volcanic activity. SLIM has successfully reached this Sea of Nectar, and if anything goes well, in the next weeks it will investigate the composition of rocks that may help scientists uncover the origins of the moon. SLIM also brings along Lunar Excursion Vehicles, LEVs, equipped with an array of instruments including thermometers, radiation monitors, and inclinometers. LEV-1, a lunar rover, features a hopping mechanism, while LEV-2, or SORA-Q, is a tiny rover developed in collaboration with TOMI, Sony Group, and Doshisha University, capable of changing its shape for lunar surface exploration. Japan's successful SLIM touchdown surely signifies a pivotal moment in its space exploration endeavors. Joining the elite club of nations with a soft landing on the moon, the country's technological prowess and scientific contributions are on full display. Not only the mission could help further our lunar knowledge, but also underscores Japan's commitment to pushing the boundaries of space exploration. It would be such a shame if something went wrong. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. No energy, no party. Regrettably, something did go wrong. Specifically, the solar panels of SLIM's small rovers are unable to generate power, hindering their functionality. Despite this setback, JAXA has confirmed that the rovers were successfully launched and data is being transmitted back to Earth. However, the solar battery of SLIM is not producing power and is expected to last only a few more hours. The current focus is to maximize data collection on the lunar landing and moon exploration using the remaining battery life. The problem now is that for the mission to be considered fully successful, space officials need to confirm whether SLIM made a pinpoint landing or not. Given that the rovers can't generate energy, this is hard to tell. JAXA thinks that while more time is needed, it was most likely achieved, based on the observation of data showing the spacecraft's movement until the landing and its ability to transmit signals after landing. But let's suppose JAXA's right and a pinpoint landing has been performed. Here's how it happened. The pinpoint landing. SLIM, also known as the Moon Sniper, initiated its descent at midnight on Saturday. Within 15 minutes, it had reached an altitude of about 10 kilometers or 6 miles above the lunar surface, as reported by the space agency. Once at an altitude of 5 kilometers, 3 miles, the lander shifted into vertical descent mode. At 50 meters or 165 feet above the surface, SLIM was expected to maneuver parallel to locate a secure landing spot. Equipped with pads on each of its 5 legs to soften the impact, SLIM aimed to touch down near the Scioli crater. The main feature of this mission is SLIM's capability to scan the moon's surface and identify familiar landmarks that are well known to astronomers and past space missions. Utilizing its onboard navigation system, SLIM precisely guided its small spacecraft to land within 100 meters of its target. The spacecraft employs a two-step landing method, where the main landing gear is the first to make contact with the ground. To ensure stability, the spacecraft rotates forward before its front leg gently touches down, enabling SLIM to achieve a secure and smooth landing on the moon's surface. In light of these achievements, Japan now joins the rank as the 5th country to have successfully landed on the moon. Preceding Japan, India became the 4th country to achieve this feat in the previous year. China accomplished its 3rd successful moon landing in 2013. The United States, with the Apollo 11 mission in 1969, became the 2nd country to reach the moon, while Russia claimed the honor of being the first in 1959 with its robotic lander. Other recent moon failures. Other recent missions have highlighted how difficult a safe touchdown on the lunar surface can be. Last year, Japanese company iSpace's Hakuto R lunar lander fell 3 miles, or 4.8 kilometers, before crashing into the moon during a landing attempt in April. These animations show the landing site before and after the impact. A Russian mission dubbed Luna 25 also crash-landed in August during the country's first attempt to return to the moon since the fall of the Soviet Union. This created a 10-meter crater on the moon. Last but not least, Astrobotic's Peregrine mission, which lifted off January 8th, marked the first lunar landing mission to launch from the United States in decades. But a crucial fuel leak forced the lander to abandon its goals just hours later. This time, though, no crash on the moon took place. The spacecraft, rather, burned up as it re-entered the Earth's atmosphere on January 18th. The controlled re-entry happened over open water in the South Pacific. At this point, one might be wondering why it is so hard to get to the moon if we have already done it. Well, you see, there might be various reasons behind that. Take NASA, for example. During the space race, NASA spent a staggering $25 billion on Apollo. It still clunked up failure after failure before it reached the moon. It now has 70 years of institutional knowledge and a culture geared towards designing, building, and testing spacecraft under its new Commercial Lunar Payload Services, CLPS, scheme. However, the agency is looking to slash costs and stimulate the U.S. space industry by paying private companies, such as Astrobotic and the Houston-based Intuitive Machines, to deliver its instruments to the moon. The trade-off is a greater risk of failure, so more lost missions should be expected. These companies are all relatively new, and comparatively, they are doing these missions on pocket change, says Dr. Joshua Rishera, a research associate at Imperial College London. But the strategy should pay off, he says, because companies learn from their failures. It still ends up being cheaper over the total number of missions, he says, even if the first few maybe crash. Moreover, every space agency, whether public or private, is rebuilding, or building from scratch, its know-how, because, let's remember, know-how is not just the set of theoretical and practical knowledge needed to do something, which potentially everyone can learn, but also the experience gained. Certainly, the engineers who worked on, say, Luna 24 more than 47 years ago have by now retired. If for decades Roscosmos has not worked on a project of this kind for the agency, it's almost like starting lunar missions from scratch, even though it was one of the probes from the lunar program, Luna 10, that first orbited our natural satellite back in 1966. Simply put, venturing to the moon has always been challenging, and it likely will remain so for years to come. Space exploration is a complex, costly, and awe-inspiring endeavor. That's all for this video. What are your thoughts on the SLIM mission? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.